Weeks into enforced social distancing dito sa Maynila, mainit-init pa rin ang ating politika. Over the past few days, nakita natin a string of NBI subpoenas filed against ordinary netizens but also some major figures. Now, this brings us back dun sa one of the major concerns sa new special authorities or special powers na binigay kay Pangulo Duterte under the We Heal As One Act na pinasa the other week. Based on Section 6 ng new Special Authorities Act na binigay kay Pangulo Duterte, there could be criminal liabilities for, quote, people spreading false information regarding the COVID-19 crisis on social media and other platforms. In fact, the penalties could go up to 2 months in jail and up to 1 million pesos. So mataas na jail time and mataas na fines. That should deter, of course, people from misusing their freedoms to contribute to fear and paranoia under very difficult conditions. Problema lang is two things. Una, what is really the definition of misinformation or fake news? Hindi masyadong klaro yung ating legislatures when it came to the drafting of the law. Hindi rin masyado klaro yung ating executive agencies on how they exactly define what misinformation and fake news is. So this opened up space for what some critics see as potential abuse and crackdown on critics of the administration. In fact, two citizens who received subpoenas for supposed spreading misinformation and fake news were defended by one of the leading human rights lawyers in the Philippines, Chel Diokno. Ayon sa kanya, one of the cases actually involved a person who was accused of engaging in misinformation, pero actually ang ginawa niya was fair commentary on a matter of public and national interest. So for human rights groups and lawyers like Chel Diokno, mukhang ang nangyari dito is not protection of public order but cracking down on any critical point of view by any ordinary citizens. Well, uminit palalo yung sitwasyon when NBI also filed a subpoena against no less than the mayor of Pasig, Vico Soto, for supposed violation of the provision of the new Special Powers Act or Special Authorities Act na binigay kay Pangulo Duterte. The problem though is, immediately na-reverse ito ng DILG. Well, uminit lalo yung politika when the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission, at least one of their commissioners, suddenly also suggested that there could be cases filed against the Vice President of the Republic, Lenny Robredo, for supposedly competing with government agencies by providing services to the frontliners.
Ang response ng Office of Vice President is that ridiculous and inappropriate any indication na her efforts to help the country, especially the frontliners, through giving dormitories, through transportation systems, through protective gears. In fact, she's helping the situation, so you should not punish a constructive effort by the Vice President. Ito po yung position ng Office of the Vice President. And it seems a lot of netizens and people across the country have agreed with that. In short, don't punish competence.
Now, no surprise that suddenly another commissioner from the same PACC commission began to sing to a different tune. Ayon sa kanya, personal opinion lang ng co-commissioner niya yung criticism that the Vice President is competing with government agencies and therefore potentially violating the law. So ano ba talaga nangyari dito? Are these honest mistakes? Is this a matter of miscommunication among different government agencies or actually officials within different agencies or commissions? Or is this something more sinister? Are some people looking for some chilling effect in order to dissuade any criticism, including legitimate criticism, by any Filipino against how this enhanced community quarantine is being implemented? Let's just hope this was nothing but an honest mistake, even though it happened, it seems, multiple times. Ako po si Richard Haydarian, and I stand for truth.